Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Friends, viewers, and other YouTube reviewers, welcome back to my channel. My name is Red, and I'm from Canada. And my YouTube channel is Let's Do This. Now I'm back to continue the third week of December. What seven fragrances have I worn? But before that, I thank you guys for coming back, for tuning in to my channel. Now, I also would like to thank my three subscribers, because last night I only have 11 subscribers. And I'm very happy that I have now 14. So YouTube newbie, I'm already happy with that baby steps, a little increase of numbers in subscription, subscribers, and viewership. May I appeal to you guys, if this is your first time, or you are a returning subscriber, or you are a returning viewer but hasn't subscribed yet, please guys, please like and subscribe to this new YouTube channel, Let's Do This. Now I'm going to start now with my first choice, but before that, what are those seven fragrances and how are they classified? In these seven fragrances, I have three Middle Eastern, I have one niche brand or one niche fragrance, I have one designer fragrance, I have one ladies perfume, and finally I have one discontinued rare vintage perfume for men. This is very interesting, as I've worn them on the third week of December. So I think that this, if I would compute it on the 16th until yesterday, the 23rd. All right. So let me begin with the first one. I will show you the first Middle Eastern fragrance. This is from the house of Lattafa. And this is a newly acquired or newly purchased perfume. So I am not sponsored, obviously, by any company. So these are all coming from my pocket. Okay, this is from Lattafa, and it's Lattafa's Sarwa Silver. Lattafa Sarwa Silver. That's the box. And here is the fantastic bottle. Now, I'm just gonna give you an overview of how it smells, and then what occasions is this suitable to wear, and how is the performance, because this is new to me. So what I can smell on this one is mint. This is a mint based fragrance that has lavender, clary sage. It also has some musk and vetiver. Now I noticed that the composition is kind of like notes belonging to, should I consider kind of like the lightweights, except probably the musk. And I would say that this is really a mint based fragrance. The mint dominates throughout the duration of the scent journey. Now, what would I say about this perfume? How's the performance of this one? It's just decent. You know, I noticed that if a perfume has some mint, normally the perfume doesn't last a long time. So this lasted on me for just 5 to 6 hours, and then at the first half an hour, the projection is really good. well, initially there's some alcohol. The projection is really good, and then you can already feel the lavender and the mint coming out from my skin initially. And then I noticed that the mint continues to travel up until before the dry down of the scent. Now the dry down is it has become like woody, soapy, and just a little earthiness coming from the vetiver. All right, so this is Sarawa Silver. The projection is average. The longevity is like 5 to 6 hours. The occasion, suitable occasion to wear this, I would suggest this is really good for work and casual scenarios. You can even wear this for formal. And then this is also good for like after the shower, when you finish your fitness, or after gym, this would be a good one. But make sure, guys, before you use this after gym, please take a shower. That's Sarawa Silver from Lattafa. Is there any comparison with other perfumes?
I didn't get that.
It's the Siri, sorry. Aqua di Farma Country Club would be kind of like on the same ballpark with this one. They're not the same by the smell, but when I smell the mint, it kind of reminds me of Aqua di Parma Country Club. And then it also reminded me a little bit over the at the beginning of the dry down, I can sense some vibes of Chanel Platinum Egoist, and also a vibe of Chanel Pour Monsieur Concentré. Those three perfumes are what I would say that this Sarawa Silver is kind of like on the same ballpark. And remember, those two Chanels for men are just a little vibe of what I can smell of this one over the dry down. Do I like this? It's okay. It's nothing spectacular. It didn't wow me. I just like the gentlemanly feel of the smell. The same feeling that I have experienced with Aqua di Parma Country Club. That's the first one. Second one would be another Middle Eastern fragrance from the house of Rasasi. And guys, you all know about this already. It's from Rasasi's Layukawam. Now, Layukawam by Rasasi is a leather-based fragrance with some berries on it. And I would say that I like this better than Tom Ford Tuscan Leather, because this has more sweetness, because I find Tuscan Leather to be well blended but leaning more on the dry leather side, while this one, it also has some dry leather aspect into it, but there's added sweetness and there's a hint of creaminess on this one. That's why I prefer this over over Tuscan Leather by Tom Ford. Now, this is very strong. This lasts me for like 12 hours, even more. And the projection of this one in just a couple of sprays, it is really beast. And it cuts in the cold wind of extreme winter. You all know, guys, I live in Canada at the Rocky Mountain part of Alberta. So our weather is truly an extreme, I should say, part of the extreme cold weather. That's why it is very suitable to use those very potent and strong scents. Layukawam. It is beast mode in projection, it is beast mode in longevity. The projection and sillage of this one is above average to heavy. And then, do I get compliments with this one? Yes, I did. Do I get compliments with the Sarawa Silver? No, I didn't when I wore it, but this one, I got compliments on this. And normally when I use this one and any perfumes I have, I sprayed about 5 sprays inside my chest and in this part of the neck. Now, if I'm not going to work, say if I'm on days that I'm not working, that's the time that I sprayed on the two sides of my neck and then even at the back. But then since I wear this at work, although this is not suitable for work, the only exception is I am in a province where our weather is extremely cold, so I can wear this to the workplace, but I make sure that I spread it inside my clothing. Now, even if I spread this inside my clothing, it comes out, it doesn't gag me. Fortunately, fragrances doesn't gag me when I overspray inside. And I get compliment on this because the scent trail is soft and it's coming out softly, and then the people can smell when I pass by, they can smell the whiff only of the soft aspect of my perfume. This one is a compliment getter. Comparing to Tom Ford Tuscan Leather, I prefer this one. The third one would be another Lattafa, another Rasasi. And this is Rasasi's Kasamat Rasana. Rasasi's Kasamat Rasana. I don't know if you can see it from the camera. And then that's the box, and here is the bottle. It's a beautiful bottle. Now this perfume is, I would say it's unisex, but it's leaning more on feminine, leaning more on for the women. Although wear this because this is truly, very alluring. The smell is fresh, it is spicy, it's very aromatic, and there's flowers into this one. That's why I said it's leaning more on the feminine side. But there is an aspect to this that has this like similar DNA with Creed Aventus, with Club de Nuit, and not on Cedra, a little similarity with the Nishane Hachivat at the beginning, maybe because of the citrus, probably some pineapple or bergamot apple note in this one. That's why it becomes like on the same ballpark of Aventus and the rest of the gang. Okay, now this is very long lasting. It lasts to me more than 8 hours, and then the projection is massive. The longevity, yeah, it is also, it's as I've said, it lasts more than 8 hours. The projection in central is really, really obvious. Guys and ladies, do not overspray this one as this is potent. This is suitable for, what I would say would be, this is suitable for date situations. If you have a date with your partner, this is also suitable for formal occasions. This is suitable also for work, as long as you lessen the spray. Okay, that's Kasamat Rasana from the house of Rasasi. Yeah, that's it. Up to the next one. This is the number four. Let's go, women. This is a vintage classic. This is Lolita Lempicka for women. This is Astar Anise. This is licorice. This is cherry. This is incense. This is vanilla. And the rest of the other notes. Now, I like this one in the middle stage and the dry down. Top note is also, it's quite strong at the first. But I would say that the top note is quite pleasant also, even if it's strong. But as it turns into the middle note and the dry down, this one is, I would say, very attractive. Again, the projection of this one is above average. The longevity lasts to me for like 6 to 8 hours. And then it stays close to skin. And I get compliments with this one. Ladies and men loves the smell of this in the air. I would say this is kind of like sensual, sweet, sensual, spicy, with some added incense with it. I think it's not a churchy kind of smell. No, the blend of the star anise combined with licorice and cherry and iris. It is a certain concoction that attracts both genders. When they smell you as you pass by, they will really turn heads and they will really ask you, in my experience, "Hey, what are you wearing? You smell really good. You smell quite feminine in your perfume. Is that really a feminine perfume?" And I said, "Oh, why? Was it really a good smell, or does it really lean to feminine?" "No, it can be unisex, but the way I smell, the way she smells it on me, she thinks that it's a women's perfume. But then the way she tells me also is that the smell can be unisex." She didn't tell me, "Don't wear it again." It means that she likes the smell of this one. I have garnered through the years very good compliments with Lolita Lempicka, this classic for women. Okay, the next one, let's go for a famous popular designer brand that was released last year, 2021. And this is from the house of Emporio Armani. And this, guys, is popular to everyone. This is a famous perfume for the past 2 years. Stronger with you, absolutely. This is my scent of the day. This got me some praises today by three of my friends. This is very Christmassy. It has rum. It has vanilla. I'm just gonna check some of the notes with this one. I think it has cinnamon and tonka bean, and it is good. I can smell the booziness straight from the atomizer. Now the main accords for this is woody, rum, vanilla, balsamic, aromatic, warm, spicy, nutty, powdery, sweet. Guys, this is a perfect blend of everything that I have read in the main accords. Indeed, I would say that it is sweet. Indeed, that there's some powdery on this one, but it was perfectly balanced with the sweetness and the soft florals from the lavender and the spiciness of the elemi. And then there's also some nuttiness from the tonka bean, as you can see. And then there's this balsamic feel too. It is. So what I can say is projection of this is above average. On my skin, it lasts for like 10 to 12 hours. Seriously, because this one can get you anosmic. Honestly, guys, this one can get you anosmic in my experience. I thought I can't smell it anymore. Sometimes I thought that the whiff under me is just soft. But no, guys, it's monstrous. Even if it's inside my clothing, when I pass by, one of my friends says, "Hey, your cologne is strong." I said, "So how do you feel about it?" He said, "It smells like Christmas." And I think it is being said in a positive way. So don't miss this one, guys. Stronger with you by important. Stronger with you, absolutely, by Emporio Armani. Okay, on to the next one. This one, I would go for the niche. This is the niche, a perfume that I have in these 7 fragrances. So this is the only niche in the group. Up until now, I would tell you guys that this is still kind of like being talked about in the fragrance community. Why? Because this is timeless. This is a very strong Tobago. This is a very strong Tobago with honey. And then it also has, I think, incense once again. And there is a floral undertone with this. There is rose, there's musk, there is iris. That's why definitely you can sense some powdery in this one. And then there's amber for a tad sweetness. And then the tobacco leaf and honey. And the weird note, hay. You know, when this is tobacco, honey, and hay, I think you can guess already. So a niche perfume from the house of Serge Lutens. It's Shergi. That's Shergi from the house of Serge Lutens. And I have Shergi number 2. So I got 2 Shergis. Now, this one is the older one. I don't know if it's an older batch, but, and then this is the current acquisition, but I have this already for about 10 years. And then I have this for about 5 years. And I got this and I purchased this in full. But I've been using this first, or I've been using this now because I set this aside. Why? When this arrives, it's a lighter brown. Now, after some years, it has become the same dark brown. They said that if you have vanilla note in your fragrance, there's a tendency that the light brown of the liquid would turn into a dark brown eventually as time passed by. But I noticed in the set of notes of Serge Lutens Shergi, of this Shergi, there's no vanilla in the scent composition. Maybe there should be, or maybe there is, because I can smell vanilla on this one. I hope I'm not deceived by the amber, or there's no tonka bean on the list of notes also, but I hope I wasn't deceived by the amber. That's why I thought it's vanilla, but for sure, to my nose, I can detect vanilla here. That's why, I guess that's the reason why the colors have changed through time. Now, this is a beast mode. This is a beast mode in projection, in silage, and also in longevity. Now, I cannot use this at work because it turns really very powdery on my skin, but in a very good way. And besides, a lot of people, especially if it's in a workplace, they may not like the smell of this one. But as I've said, guys, I live by the mountains in the extreme cold province of Canada, which is Alberta. I think I'm lucky because I can wear the strength. I can wear this kind of smell, just like the movie Gladiator. Yeah, strength and honor. I'm very happy to have this one. Aside from workplace, where's the suitable? Which occasions would this be suitable to use? I would say formal. I would say on dating situations, as long as you only keep like a couple of sprays. This can also go for clubbing, and this would work also on outdoor activities. But you can never use this on summertime, and I don't think I can use this on springtime also. So summer and spring, nah, I won't use this one. But then that's it. Shergi from the house of Serge Lutens. And finally, the last one. For the last one, this, guys, well, thank you first for tuning in up to this time, okay? It's been about more than 20 minutes already. Pardon me because my English is quite slow, and every sentence that I would say has to be edited because English is not my first language. Anyways, done with chit-chat with that one. The last one, this is a rare gem. This is a legend. And this one is truly hard to find. And if you will be able to find this one, expect that the price is really high. From the house of Gucci, I think this was released during the 80s. And a lot of people have been talking about this, wanting to own this one. But I was able to grab a 30 ml, actually two of them, but I sold the other one. Anyways, from the house of Gucci, the legend, the might, the power, the expensive or luxurious smelling, this is Gucci Nobile. And this is my old bottle of Gucci Nobile. Now, how does this smell? Guys, this is an all-star kind of notes. I don't know what the notes are, but I would just tell you the impression. Imagine Drakkar Noir, either the vintage or the formulation for 20 years, or the vintage in the 70s. imagine Drakkar Noir. You make it more refined, but at the same time, you make it stronger. And then imagine if Drakkar Noir for you on your skin, if you still remember it, is quite linear. This Gucci Nubile is transforming. Now and then it keeps on changing. The might is stronger than Drakkar Noir. The similarity, not 100%, Drakkar Noir to this one is there, but this is more classy. This is more luxurious smelling. This is more like a real man smell, but it gets more compliments in my experience compared to Drakkar Noir, because it smells more refined, it smells more natural ingredients, and then it smells more aromatic. The longer it stays in your skin, the better the smell becomes. And this lasts to me, guys, more than 12 hours. Fantastic smell. Now, where is the best situations to wear this one? I would say formal. There's a formal occasion. I would say if you are going on a nightclub or if you are clubbing, I wouldn't say this is good for dates. I wouldn't say this is great for work or this is suitable for work. Nope. Maybe a upper class event, formal event, and then this would be good also when you're going on parties, okay? And then this would be good also when you're going outdoors, like you're going on a sports, probably when you're planning to go on golf, and then you would go outdoors. A golf game would be good for this one, I think. And then if you have some activities outdoors, like friends, you're gonna have some barbecue outdoors, this would be also good. Because this Gucci Nubile, when combined with the cold air of fall and winter, this is perfect. This becomes alive. Do I get compliments with this? Yeah, definitely. Anyways, guys, that's the 7 fragrances I have worn on the third week of December, beginning December 16 until yesterday, the other day, December 23. Thank you so much for correction. The Stronger With You by Emporio Armani, absolutely. I didn't wear it yesterday because I thought it was 23rd yesterday. I got mixed up with the dates. I wore this on the last December 23. Today is December 25. That's Christmas Day today. Merry Christmas, guys. I wish you all the best and be blessed all the time with your family and loved ones. Always be on the positive side of things. And please, may I appeal to you, please subscribe and help me out, back me up, this humble newbie in the YouTube fragrance game would increase its numbers. Up until then, and to all of you guys who are having trouble in expressing their thoughts in English, for that reason you are having second doubt, or you are having some doubts on creating your own YouTube channel, and here's the deal: if I can do this, you can do this. Let's do this. Cheers, guys. God bless. Until next video.